So your brain cell requires that more oxygen, 25% not more oxygen, that you receive when you're laughing. So when you're laughing, then that supply of oxygen increases to your brain cells and you become very active and fresh. So always remember, 14 hours of work or 15 hours of work, take a break, laugh and see the difference. Laughter yoga has an ability to eliminate any kind of stress, be it physical, mental, emotional, psychological. All these things can be eliminated through laughter yoga. It's time to take laughter seriously for your health, for your happiness, and keep spreading this joy and laughter, not just for yourself, but people around you.
Welcome to the Stars of Learning podcast, where your host Jyoti Ji explores the minds of the thought leaders who have vast experience and in-depth knowledge in the learning industry. Now, over to your host, Jyoti Ji.
Hello everyone, hearty welcome to Season 2 of Stars of Learning podcast, and I'm your host, Jyoti Ji.
And each fortnight, I interview the thought leaders who will share their best practice of learning. We will also discuss challenges, solutions, latest trends, tools, technology, leadership, and their journey in the learning arena. So friends, glad you're joining me today. And today we are unveiling an interesting topic, and that is laughter yoga. You can also say hasya yoga. And this is for health and happiness, which is a modern exercise involving prolonged voluntary laughter. And this definitely has a medicinal effect by doing a laughter yoga. And there's no joke, friends. Even forcing a little bit on doing this laughter, your health benefits are many. And we notice that there are many people, or why people in more than 100 countries have joined laughter yoga clubs, and doctors also prescribe laughter to the sick, elderly, young and healthy for the kind of a lifestyle we are leading, and to definitely to, you know, reduce the stress what we are going through. So you might be wondering, what is laughter yoga and what is it's a series of breathing and relaxation exercise, and I will not get into the depth of what it is and the science of it and all that. So friends, I have practiced laughter yoga and I have been part of few of the session, and what I experienced is that, you know, it definitely boosts your immune system, and it's something, a unique concept, like unconditional laughter, and anyone can laugh for no reason, and that's what I experienced in the process. And it's just not with, there are no jokes or humor or any comedy happening there, but you just laugh, you bring that laughter element in yourself. Yeah, and once you start doing that, it becomes real, so real, and it becomes contagious, where you spread it to others also. So when I heard from one of the experts the concept of this laughter yoga, and they said this is based on the scientific fact that our body cannot differentiate between a fake and real laughter. So you will get loads of benefit through this process. As usual, I believe you can fast track when you learn from an expert who is already doing this kind of a practice. And in this podcast, I have invited Archana Rao, chosen to be the Laughter Ambassador in the Global Laughter Yoga Forum representing India. So friends, Archana comes with over 2 decades of experience in areas of corporate, talent search, wellness consulting and life coaching. She heads Laughter Yoga India for the past 5 years, an organization created to spread the essence of laughter in human living in areas of health, happiness and peace. And recently she has been interviewed by SBS TV channel in Australia, Indian Express and Radio City channels. And I have seen a lot of live sessions on the Instagram and the Facebook. So owing to her presence in corporate talent management space, she understands, you know, how stress is affecting work-life balance for most of us, and she provides laughter yoga session as a natural remedy for today's stressful and busy life what we lead. So friends, she does these sessions by using a variety of tools and techniques like music, some sound, dance and meditation part. She blends the whole process to you and bring that joy of laughter element with you. So her mantra is in life to spread the joy of laughter to one and all. And she has so far touched over 40,000 plus people lives through laughter yoga. And she has been successfully delivering sessions for corporate giants, the big giants, you name them a few. And her social cause endeavors for schools, colleges, senior citizens, as well as cancer patients. And these have shown remarkable results, friends. And she intends to do a research project to understand how laughter yoga could be used as a means to address the various coping up issues with individuals in these entities. So today she is the most renowned laughter yoga trainer in the country, doing high impact sessions for corporate. So a life coach, a Reiki master, a Tibetan sound bowl healer, access bar conscious practitioner, laughter yoga guru, and an amazing human being, which I have come across. And as I said, friends, I made the joyous discovery, and that 30 minutes of genuine belly laughter when I had met Archana, it's still mesmerizing to me. Back few years when I connected during in one of our L&D group where she did this session, and the results were so relaxing, friends. It was fun throughout, and what's more is you can start practicing these techniques from day one itself, and your mood is definitely uplifting, and it is so, it will be so fresh and bright as you go through this process. As I said, I'm sure you're going to enjoy this conversation. So buckle up and get ready to understand laughter yoga for health and happiness. So with no further ado, let me welcome my one and only guest, Archana Rao, laughter yoga guru. Hey Archana, ho ho, ha ha ha.
Hi Jyoti. So let us start with laughter, huh? About making a laughter challenge since we are talking about laughter. Yeah?
Yes.
Here we go. Yeah. Yeah, see, beautiful, so, beautiful. It's so easy to laugh.
Right. Your laughter is contagious, Archana. So, hearty welcome to the Stars of Learning podcast.
Thank you, Jyoti.
So, Archana, before we start on this interesting topic on this laughter yoga, a little background about yourself, how you got to where you are today. You were in the corporate and now you're outside the corporate. So, a quick journey.
Sure.
How you got to laughter yoga?
So, I worked in corporate and then I moved from corporate and got into an HR executive search firm, which I headed, called Do Kaizen. In 2009 till 2013, I was supporting corporates in their niche and leadership hiring in India and international. And I believe recruitment is a fantastic business, but it also comes with its own challenges and stress. And that too, when you're hiring for global leaders, the stress becomes more. So one such situation happened in 2013 when after putting in a lot of efforts, I kind of had a little loss in business. And just like any normal person, I was undergoing stress and worry and tension. And that is when I started looking at things that would bring in more joy and happiness in my life. And I came to know about laughter yoga through a TED talk. And just watching an 18 minutes of video about laughter yoga at 10:30 in the night shifted my mood like how. I mean, At 10:15, 10:20, I'm just sitting and wondering, am I in the right space? Am I supposed to quit this business? What am I supposed to do next? I'm not enjoying this. And here I'm watching a TED talk of 18 minutes and it just made me smile and laugh doing nothing and just watching the video. So that inspired me that, yes, there is something like laughter yoga. And I started doing little research and got myself trained and certified in 2013 and 14. And since then, the journey has been fantastic. The shift has happened from HR background, from corporate background, from heading an executive search firm to laughter yoga. This is more meaningful. This is more purpose in life now. through laughter yoga.
Wow, wonderful. I think that would be an, a proud moment for you to being the chosen to be the laughter ambassador too.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah. So thanks for that note, Archana, on, you know, that 18 minutes which made that shift.
Yes.
So let's deep dive. What's that 18 minutes got you? Like, what is laughter yoga and why laughter yoga?
Sure. So let me first share to all our listeners what is laughter yoga. So laughter yoga, as we all know, it's a unique concept where anybody can laugh without any reason. We don't rely on jokes. We don't rely on comedy. But what we do is we ideally connect in a small group and we have an eye-to-eye contact of the other group members. We bring in childlike playfulness and that childlike playfulness becomes real and contagious. The laughter becomes real and contagious. So initially, few seconds, people may think that we are faking our laughter. So for example, when we started this podcast, I said, let's laugh. So first for 3 to 5 seconds, it felt like we were faking it, but laughter is contagious. Over a period of time, it becomes real. And the only reason why we call this as laughter yoga is because we bring in a lot of deep breathing exercise like we do in pranayama. That's the only reason why it is called as laughter yoga. And as you rightly said, you know, it's a scientific fact that our body cannot differentiate between real or a fake laughter. We still get the same physical, mental, emotional, and psychological benefit. So how about faking something which has got so much of benefit and we are not harming anybody? and this was introduced by a medical doctor, Dr. Madan Kataria in India in 1995 in Mumbai in a small park with just 5 members as a group. And as on today, there are thousands of laughter clubs spread across the world. So that is how laughter came to me. This, I must say, I should thank that stress and worry and tension which came. Because sometimes in life, when these things come, is when innovation comes, new ideas come.
Yes.
So that's
you break the ceiling there.
Yeah, exactly. So that's how laughter came into my life. And then, of course, from then on, it is all beautiful, beautiful journey. And I've been enjoying life to the fullest since then.
Sure. Interesting one, Archana. So, Archana, you know, when I interact with people, the most forgotten jewel which we as a human can wear is a smile. And we are talking about laughing, right?
Yeah.
So, help my listeners understand why we need to laugh more today. Because, you know, you say there are scientific proven health benefits and there are deep breathing exercise through laughter yoga. So just give us that insight why we need to laugh.
very, very good question. In fact, 5-6 years back in one of the corporate session, the first thing, why should we laugh? And I'm like, are you? Then I will ask, why do you need to breathe? So the human life is supposed to be, we are supposed to live happy, joyful, experience everything good. But what happens is, instead of that, we start getting into a lot of struggle, challenges, pain, experiences and all. And we forget to laugh. Now, when we are laughing, we need to understand that we are releasing endorphins, which are feel-good hormone. So when you are releasing these endorphins, which are feel good hormone, you are happy and joyful. So if you are in a happy and joyful mood, you're working or you're doing anything, that will definitely give you fantastic results. So that itself is a big reason. So whatever you are doing, be it being in a good relationship, be it your work, be it taking care of home or children, and all of these require so much of energy. Now, if you're laughing and being happy and joyful, I'm sure each and every task that you do will add with very good results. So one is that. And second most important thing which I want to share to all our listeners is when you are laughing for 15 minutes as a practice every single day, you don't fall sick because your immune system will build up. What do we do in laughter? We are saying, ha, 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 ha. We are laughing, right?
Right.
So what we are doing is we are exhaling all the stale air from our lungs while doing so. And we are not even, so if I ask everybody to sit and do pranayama, particularly with children or people, sometimes it becomes difficult because mind is so much chattering that you're not able to focus. But if I make you guys laugh, you're already laughing and exhaling all the stale air from your lungs. That means it's bringing in so much goodness in your life. One is immune system, and second, when laughter yoga has the ability to eliminate any kind of stress, be it physical, mental, emotional, psychological, all these things can be eliminated through laughter yoga. And one last most important thing which I want to share to all our listeners right now is, see, our brain cells requires 25% more oxygen for functioning nicely and actively. And in today's world where so much is happening around us, forget about that 8 hours and 10 hours of office work. We are like almost working 15 hours and 18 hours constantly. Though we are working from home, there is so much. So your brain cell requires that more oxygen, 25% not more oxygen, that you receive when you're laughing. So when you're laughing, the net supply of oxygen increases to your brain cells and you become very active and fresh. So always remember, 14 hours of work or 15 hours of work, take a break, laugh and see the difference.
Sure. I think that's an amazing three tips what you have shared, pointers. Yes. Archana. Yes. So is there any process we need to follow? You did say 15 minutes a daily practice definitely boosts in many segments. How do we follow this process?
Very simple, just laugh. well, there is definitely a process. So when we say process, I address different age group, right? So I address children. So when we are laughing with children, it is little different. You cannot be giving them gyan with children. You will just laugh with them, right?
Seriously. Yeah.
When I'm dealing with corporates,
meditation and pranayama and all, they will run.
So there it is more of fun and just laugh. But but when it comes to corporate, which is more of logical, which is more of stress, which is more of questioning and reasoning and all of that, there it is little different. Again, we need to first bring them out of their comfort zone and maybe a little bit of clapping, saying ho ho ha ha and so on and so forth. And then again, if it is cancer patients, then you cannot be delivering what you are doing with corporate, because cancer patients are already undergoing the treatment and they cannot be very physically active the way children could be or the way the young group could be. So each of these laughter exercise or activities are customized. I customize these programs depending upon whom am I addressing. But very simple. Anybody can laugh. Just start with simple clapping and say, ho, ho, ha, ha, ho, ha, ho, ha, and laugh.
That is how
the entire, these programs are designed and customized. The needs are different, you see. The needs are different for different people.
So Archana, that's an interesting one, and I follow you on Facebook, and I noticed that with time, right, a lot of negative impact is having on our everyday lifestyle, and the stress is actually piling up. Like you said, 15 to 18 hours working, and definitely it breaks sometimes, right? It breaks our bodies down, and many of them I encounter, they say, there's no smile, there's no happiness, and it's so thing that it's stressful. And that's the state of a common man which we have come across, and you have shared a simple insight, like simply laugh and for 15 minutes and all. And you are also saying that you're associated with cancer patients and you say it has benefited them. So can you throw some light for these adults to know that how it will help, and laughter yoga can heal even the illness element also?
Definitely, I'll be more than happy to answer this question, and not just restricting it for cancer patients, but overall, if anybody is going through any physical ailment, this is applicable to all of you. So the first thing is, when you are going through any sort of pain, you are also in your mind. That means you are thinking a lot. You are taking a lot of stress and pressure and tension. And particularly with cancer patients, while they are undergoing their chemotherapy or radiation, the physical body is also giving up, and mentally they are worried of so many things. So if you remember, I said one thing about laughter yoga, it builds your immune system. Because when you're laughing, you're ha 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 ha, you're doing, you're exhaling all the stale air, right? So for cancer patient, what is important once they undergo this therapy is to ensure that their immune system is good. So through laughter yoga, first, one of the most important thing that is taken care is definitely immune system. Number two, eliminating stress, because even they undergo stress, because as I said, it is not just the physical, but even the emotional. And on physical front, they go through, yeah, their taste buds are not there. They are not able to think much. There is a lot of fear. There is a lot of pain and struggle. Now, if they are laughing and if the minds are relaxed and happy, the treatment also works in a nice way. In fact, US National Library of Medicine and National Institute of Health has done research on how, you know, laughter yoga is helping in healing cancer patients. And there are n number of medical research, if you can just Google it out. Throughout the world, there has been research happening that how laughter yoga is helping in healing cancer patients while they undergo the, it is not that they don't undergo the radiation or all of that. But along with that, when they are laughing, at least it brings in little bit of ease the way they look up to this entire scenario. And it's not just the cancer patients, even their family members. So one of the situation that I just wanted to share is we were delivering this session for terminally ill cancer patients for a Christmas in Bangalore at Karnashraya. So the first question that came up is, Archana, these are terminally ill cancer patients. What are we going to achieve? I said, I don't know, but I am here to bring in little bit of joy, bring in little laughter in their life. And you will be surprised, Jyoti, what happened after the session is, we had family members who just came and hugged, like how, and what they shared really, even today when I'm sharing, Jyoti, brings goosebump to me, where they said, it is very painful to see our loved ones passing away. And these are last moments. But you gave us a memory for lifetime where we have laughed together, even in so much of pain and struggle. So that's something what I am talking about, terminally ill cancer patients. But we are also going to, very soon, as I said, we're going to do a research in India with one of the largest hospital, which we already spoke this year in February, but because of pandemic, we could not stop. So once we do a proper medical research in India, also the awareness will grow and people will understand that, yes, these therapies work. These therapies definitely help them to overcome the, these pain and struggling times.
This is really emotional touch, Archana. I hope I am able to add value by sharing this insight to my listeners so that, you know, they benefit and they reap. Laughter yoga is one strategy which they should be looking upon.
Can I share just one more thing which transformed my life? I think your listeners would love to listen to this part of it if I can, with regards to cancer patient.
Sure.
So I often go to Ahmedabad in Gujarat, which is my hometown, and I deliver the session for Gujarat Cancer Society. So one of the turning point that came in my life is while delivering a laughter yoga session for, again, terminally ill cancer patient at Gujarat Cancer Society. You'll not believe, after finishing the session, I was asking a simple question to the caretakers, to the family members and doctors and nurses. That how did you like the session? What are you going to do with this, what I've taught? What is your next step? And nobody could answer. But there was this guy sitting in front of me. I think he had a throat cancer or something. He just pulled my pant. These guys were sitting down. So he just pulled my pant and he said, Havethi hu roj hasis, jeevis tyasudhi hasis. That means I will laugh till my last day of my life. Till I die, I will be laughing. I think that's the turning point in my life, that we don't have to go through that level to understand the strength and beauty of laughter. Our life purpose is to lead a happy and joyful life. And we are stuck with so many simple challenges. We are stuck with promotions. We are stuck with EMI. We are stuck with relationship. We are stuck with, God knows, so political issues.
Yeah.
So many steps we are stuck, Jyoti. But this man taught me and such a beautiful lesson. And till date, if there is any challenge that comes, I can never forget that guy's face who said that I'm going to laugh till the end of my life, till I am alive. So I think that's a turning point for all our listeners, that life is beautiful. There is a purpose. There is a meaning to our life. Let's just enjoy it. Rest of the things will fall in place.
That's a real touching message. Life is beautiful.
Yes.
Making it more interesting with Archana, friends. So if you're listening, get into the laughter habit. So Archana, moving on.
Yes.
I do follow you on the Facebook and on the LinkedIn, I see so lovely information you share and give insight training laughter yoga for corporates, just not for huge corporate clients, as well as for social and NGO sectors, right?
Yes.
Can you share some insights how your clients have felt, how they have gained benefit, especially corporates?
Sure, I'll be more than happy. There are many, many, many stories, but let me pick up few of them, the recent ones. One of the session that I delivered last November was for one of the largest global consulting firm where we had the leadership team. These guys are all at a very, very senior level with 20, 25 plus years of experience, guys. And after the session, when a person came and spoke to me, and he was so overwhelmed, he said, "Archana, I want to hug you." And this is very common, Jyoti, in my laughter session, where people feel so overwhelmed that they come and say, "Can I hug you?" And I'm like, I am open for hugs because I know the energy is very, very different and positive, and it's something very beautiful. So, right. So this person shared that it's been 5 years that he has been under stress and depression, undergoing through some medication. Though being at that leadership level, he has not been able to cope up with this challenge. And today, after 5 years, I'm laughing like this, Archana. And forget about laughter. I have not even smiled for these many years. And after 5 years, this is just fantastic. I could see that almost tears kind of a stuff, overjoyed and overwhelmed. I think I'll never forget that guy's face. That was beautiful. And very recent, 2 weeks back, I've been training people who would like to become laughter yoga trainers. Okay, I'm a master trainer who can train people to become laughter yoga trainers. So one of my partners who have experienced my laughter session for their team and as well as their corporate clients team, she said she would like to become a trainer, and I started training her. And you'll not believe, just 1 week of training, she said, "Archana, I'm a little stressed." I said, "What happened?" "Well, Mama is undergoing a small hip surgery during this COVID, and it's all madness. She's 75. I don't know what to do." And I taught her 2-3 exercises. I said, "This immediately you need to do with your mom. And trust me, it's going to be fine and everything is fine." And that video, people are loving it, where her mother is sitting in an hospital after her surgery, having medicine and laughing. So 75-year-old woman laughing with the medicine is something fantastic. I mean, it helps you to forget the pain and struggle. Laughter has the ability to shift your mood like how. I think these are a few of the beautiful, beautiful memories. There are many more, but these recent ones are very, very close to my heart.
Yeah. Okay, let me share my experience. You know, I've come to you a couple of sessions, so you know I should share my. So you just taught few, you know, hand techniques and all of that, and you know, just giggle and laugh and all of that, right? Mm-hmm. I travel every day 25 kilometers one way. Mm-hmm. So you know, every day I travel 50 kilometers, and Bangalore traffic is sometimes irritating. Mm-hmm. Okay. And especially somebody zooms you up and, you know, overtakes unnecessarily, you know, cut the road and all of that. You know, now what I do? I show them a thumbs up. They did a great job. I smile at them. I laugh. These people will be thinking, what mad this lady is, you know, she's doing a thumbs up and she's laughing also. I did a smart thing, they think, but you know, I'm actually enjoying the whole process here. So that's how contagious your laugh.
I must salute you, Jyoti. In fact, we have this exercise where I say, not just Bangalore, I think many cities, when it comes to traffic, imagine a fresh day in the morning, you're driving and going on the way to your office. Half of your energy has gone because you have these amazing cutlets who just don't follow any rules, and you are like blinking, what the hell has just happened? And instead of getting that frustration, instead of getting stress, because let me tell you, Jyoti, stress is contagious. If one person in the family is undergoing stress, he or she is definitely going home and, you know, And the good news is laughter is contagious too. So what you are doing is you're cutting the pattern of spreading stress. Instead of that, you're spreading laughter. Fantastic. Beautiful, beautiful.
Yeah. And people, when I walk back home, they say, "How come you're not tired? How come you have that energy?" So now I know that, you know, why, what the secret is. So thank you so much for that.
Beautiful. So
Archana, we all know that laughing is something, a very important one for our daily work. You are saying us to practice at least 15 minutes, right? So I also want to ask you this question. As not many are comfortable laughing, maybe in the group, and also they wear this mask, right? I'm an adult, I'm a senior guy. Oh, I'm such an elderly person in the family. How can I think of laughing like this? You know, how can you know, break the pattern and start laughing or practice laughter yoga?
So very, very simple. Each person has to get that eureka moment, that what is it that you want in life? Do you still want the same mask of showing yourself as very serious person? Do you still, or you want to bring in that wow moment in your life where all the good things are coming to you? So it is about individual who choose. You can choose to be in a situation of painful struggle, complaining, challenges, or you can take that one simple step of laughing, where you can experience your health. Forget about any other benefit. Right now, when we are talking about the current pandemic and all of that, it is about health. I'm saying your immune system is getting boosted. And imagine, Jyoti, when you look at somebody who's smiling and laughing, how much do you feel the positivity and get attracted? And look at the faces which are so serious, so angry, you don't even feel like looking. So you choose. Yeah. Do you want to attract wonderful people? Do you want to have wonderful experiences? Do you want to be surrounded with something really nice? Then first you take the step to smile. First you take the step to start laughing and bringing that joy in your life. Only then you will see things start shifting. So it is a choice that each one of us has to take for our health, for our benefit.
True, true. Yeah, bring that childlike element, friends. Yes. It definitely makes a difference. So, Archana, humor is something good, but, you know, people may not be comfortable with all that comedy and, you know, jokes. And sometimes some nice jokes can be taken it negatively also, right?
Correct.
So, is there a difference between laughter yoga and comedy or any jokes? What happens?
Absolutely.
So, is there a line?
Yes, yes, definitely. First and foremost, let me share this to all my listeners that I'm pathetic at jokes and comedy. If I start telling jokes or comedy, you guys will start crying. Forget about laughing. So, and Jyoti, you rightly pointed out. See, when it comes to comedy and jokes, they're always either gender biased or they are about politics or they are about putting somebody down. Wherein I am saying that we can still laugh without these jokes and comedy, because this is a practice which you are bringing in. You are not relying on external source that somebody should crack a joke, only then you will laugh. This is a practice. And anybody can laugh when the times are good, right? When the times are good or you are listening to comedy, okay, I am able to laugh. And even comedy, do you know how many seconds can you laugh for a single comedy? Hardly anything. We just giggle and then we come back. But we just come back, yeah. And half of the time, to be very honest, when I look at certain comedy show, I see everybody laughing. I said, what was so funny about this? I am not what, you know, I questioned myself. Is it my intellectual mind? I didn't understand the joke. Or what was so funny about it, right? That does not mean that I'm saying all the comedians are bad. No, not at all. But I'm saying, when you have a process like this, which you can bring in laughter and joy in your life and people around you without jokes and comedy, without relying. What if tomorrow there are no comedians? What if tomorrow there are no jokes? Then you will say, I don't even know how to laugh. So this practice is beautiful, right? Because you're not relying on any of that. So yes, laughter yoga is laughing without jokes and comedy as a simple practice.
Interesting. Yeah. So then how about yoga and laughter, Archana? Because, you know, here you mentioned earlier, like, you know, the laughter yoga is designed to get people to laugh for no reason. But I also hear you saying it is like deep breathing exercise or a meditation like pranayam, which you are saying, right? So you say there is a link between yoga and laughter. How is that?
So I wanted to share this. When we do these sessions of laughter yoga, which goes on for sometime half an hour to 1 hour, now continuously laughing will become if somebody is laughing continuously, then you need to have that proper energy, right? So what we do is with each exercise, let's say we are doing a 2-3 exercise, then in between these exercises, we do something called as deep breathing. So after one exercise, they take a nice, beautiful breathe in and breathe out. So when you do that, what are you doing? You are doing something like pranayama. And that's the only reason why we call this as laughter yoga. We are just bringing those deep breathing exercises like pranayama. And then we do the exercise. For example, we do a handshake laughter, or we do a hi-fi laughter. We are laughing, looking at each other. And then we start taking deep breathing together and breathe out together. So that's the reason why this is called as pranayama. We don't do any specific asanas because people have this doubt. Okay, it is laughter yoga. That means I need to bring my yoga mat. Am I going to lie down? Am I going to do some Surya Namaskar? No. The only reason it is called as yoga because we bring in a lot of deep breathing and breathe out in between the activities. That's the reason this is called as laughter yoga.
Yeah. I remember the one, you know, you say breathe in and like, you know, you take in and hard.
You are the most amazing participant who is remembering the entire activity. I'm happy. I'm happy.
Yeah, I practice, right?
Yeah. Amazing.
Sure. So, Archana, so what all types of exercise happens when we do laughter yoga?
So, there are various kinds of exercise. We have close to about 100 plus exercises, okay?
Wow.
But the beauty is when you become a trainer, then you don't depend on these 100 exercises. You create your own laughter exercise. Anybody can create. If you remember, I don't know if we have done something called as hand wash laughter. We just created it instantly when the pandemic began. So you can create your exercise on the situations which stresses you the most. For example, for corporates, I say, what stresses them the most is their appraisal letter, their rating. So I say, okay, now show your appraisal letter to your partners and just let's laugh instead of worrying and taking tension, and people laugh like how. So you can create so many exercises. These days we are doing vessel cleaning laughter, fruit cleaning laughter, wearing a mask laughter. So there are many. There are like hundreds of exercises that you can choose, or you can create your own exercise. In fact, 2 weeks back or 3 weeks back, I posted one of the video where one of my participant, who is an actor and from theater background from UK, Helen, she was getting trained by me, and she created a floor mopping laughter exercise, and I was like, oh my god, she's fantastic. If people want to watch that video, they can check it on my YouTube channel. You will see she's mopping and she's laughing. Can you see how much fun you can bring in rather than feeling irritated that you need to clean the house?
That's really cool. So Archana, do you also see any challenges when people are may face while practicing laughter yoga?
If you ask me, in most of the sessions, the first few minutes are not that easy. Let me be very, very honest, particularly when you're doing it with corporates and when you're doing it with senior citizens. So it takes a little while, but over a period of time, let's say after 5 to 7 minutes, because laughter is contagious, that laughter becomes real and contagious. And let's say if we have 20 people in a group and 15 people are laughing and the other 5 people are very serious, but because these 15 people are laughing, the other 5 look at them, and it is very contagious, and nobody can stop. Yeah, nobody can stop.
Okay.
This is one good thing which is contagious. So let's be happy about it.
So with that, who all can do the laughter yoga? Any prerequisite, you say, any conditions which we need to have, or any age limit, anything like that?
At all. Laughter yoga is for anybody and everybody. Only thing is, there are few things that we need to take care. Let's say if we have a early stage of pregnancy in a woman who is pregnant in an early stage, she need to be a little easy while laughing. Not that laughter has any major side effect. No, nothing at all. Guys, don't get scared. I'm not scaring you. Okay, no side effects, okay? All I'm saying is, when a woman is in an early stage of pregnancy, she need to go a little light, because when she's laughing, it may hurt, and she's laughing more than it may hurt a little bit of her tummy. And second is, if there are patients who have undergone their kidney operation or what do you call a hernia operation and all, they need to be a little easy. Otherwise, nothing at all. Everybody can laugh. Children laugh 300 times in a day and we hardly laugh anything. So please go ahead and laugh.
a good number to, you know, measure ourselves for 300.
Absolutely. So, but Jyoti, that's a, you know, one of the saddest part is what I see in India is children laugh so beautifully and parents go and hit them and say, what, you're laughing like this. So I tell all the parents who do this that, are yaar, you guys have forgotten to laugh. Now at least learn from your children. You're getting so many benefits. Even children get so many benefits. Look at the children and consider them as a trainer for a change. At your home, allow them to laugh and you laugh with them. Yeah, you laugh with them.
Yeah. It's a culture also sometimes where they play that role and say, no, you cannot laugh loudly. No, you have to.
We in India experience now, women particularly, unfortunately, few of the cultures, the upbringing is such that you are a female child. Nah? So you're like, no, you're not supposed to laugh loudly, or you keep your hand on your mouth and laugh. In fact, I have seen that in the childhood when mama used to tell, Arey bacha, you're not supposed to laugh like this. I said, come on, yaar. And now after laughter yoga, I don't care. It does not matter. Just laugh. My health is what matters most important. My happiness is what matters most important. Just laugh.
So with so many advantages and benefits, Archana, so what are the tips and tricks you want to propose to my listeners in context to laughter yoga?
Tips are very, very simple. Pick up those three or five things which bothers you the most and start making those laughter exercises. If you need any support, I'm always there to help you. So what are these things? If it is argument with your spouse, just show that finger in terms of argument and do an argument laughter. When it is about money problem, say, I don't have money, and laugh about it. So pick up all those things which bothers you the most, and for a change, laugh at that particular situation and see the difference. See the difference. You yourself will be able to understand that there's no point in taking stress for certain situations which are beyond your control. But what happens is when you're laughing, at least your health is taken care, your mood is getting elevated. And somebody asked me, Archana, does that mean that if I laugh, all my problems will be solved, my financial problems will be solved? Then I said, see, I'm not guaranteeing you for that. But yes, I can guarantee you one thing, that when you are happy, when you are joyful, when your health is good, all the good things will come to you and you will start creating those beautiful magic and miracles in your life. So if you want to have all good things in your life, forget about stress, forget about worry, start laughing out for your health and happiness.
That's lovely one, Archana. So is there anything else you would like to add that will be of value to my listeners, Archana?
Definitely. So there is something called hearing and listening. I hope all of you were listening. And if you were listening, please ensure that you are taking laughter seriously. Don't take life too seriously. It's time to take laughter seriously for your health, for your happiness, and keep spreading this joy and laughter, not just for yourself, but people around you.
wonderful. Kudos to you, Archana, in this laughter journey. So last question, how do you see learning trends in 2020?
I must say 2020 has made all of us think out of the box. We have all come out of our comfort zones, and these are the time when people have started reflecting inward. These are the time when people have started looking at self. What is it that I need to bring in myself? And lot of alternate therapies, lot of understanding in healing modality and learning. And fortunately, we are all so fortunate that during these tough situations, we have the digital platform. Everything is available at a click. So this is the time when people are meditating more. This is the time when people are learning more. These are the time when they are looking at all sorts of alternate therapies where they add value. Because see, life is changing constantly. Challenges will keep coming up. But if you have the tools and techniques that will help you to lead a happy and joyful life, these situations will not break you down. These situations will not put you down. So yes, this year is about transformation, which many of them are seeing beautifully and nicely with beautiful practices. So 2020 is all about looking inward and bringing the transformation using the digital platform and many other stuff.
Wonderful, wonderful. Archana, now we have lined up rapid fire questions for you. And this is the pattern I use in my podcast to know about our leaders who come on the Stars of Learning podcast. And these questions are targeted to know about you, which will influence my listeners to engage, enlighten, and empower. And that's the mission of my podcast too.
Do I need to laugh before I start? Are these going to be stressful questions that let me laugh out right away?
No. These are very simple and straight questions to you.
Please go.
So, according to you, what is your star moment?
My star moment is when I flied my dad back in Bangalore after a major heart surgery, where everybody gave up in life. And I had the intention very strong to my heart that no matter what, I'm going to take my dad back home. And I can never forget that moment, and always in gratitude to the universe and God for bringing that moment in my life.
And what inspires you to do everything that you do today?
I think I am an inspiration myself with all the situations that I've gone through in my life. The pain and struggle and everything is what transformed you to become a laughter yoga trainer.
Sure. And since you own a company, what's one thing you would do differently in learning?
What I think I'm already doing something very different. In today's world, people are making everybody cry, and I'm already making everybody laugh. So I'm already doing something very, very unique and different, because it's easy to make people cry. It's easy to make people emotionally down. But to uplift their mood, but to bring in the positivity, to bring in the joy and happiness is something not everybody is gifted. And I think I'm absolutely once again in gratitude to the universe for making me this laughter yoga therapist. So I think I'm already doing something very, very unique.
Interesting. And what are the three most important things you would like to accomplish right now?
What are the three most important things that I would like to accomplish right now? So one is definitely I have a very good plan of setting up the healing center, because I've been using various tools and techniques like Tibetan sound healing, laughter yoga, Reiki healer, and all of these. I want to combine all of these together and bring in more awareness in people's life and bring in more abundance and joy in people's life. So the next thing that is going to happen is laughter yoga is one part of it, but the healing center is already, I'm manifesting it. And the second thing is, which has been pending for a while, is to do a research on laughter yoga for cancer patients, which is definitely a priority post this pandemic gets over, so that we have proper research, medical research, so people will understand that, yes, there is something like this. And the third one is to find a boyfriend and get married.
Interesting. So if I may ask you, what are your strengths?
My strength is to live every day as it is, without any judgments. That is one of the biggest strengths. And of course, my strength also comes from my parents and my loved ones. Because of their constant support and people around me who have been there, I've been blessed with these people. So these are the two things. And most important is experience everything as it is without any judgment. And live every moment. That's it. That's my strength, yes.
And what's the best book you have read this year or any time you want to recommend to my listeners?
Oh my God, I don't read books at all. I'll tell you what. So I would not say sad part, each one of us are unique. So for me, when I start reading book, even if it is a half a page or one page, I just sleep off. So I cannot read books, to be very, very honest. All those listeners who are very good at reading, please don't scold me. It's time for me and you to laugh together for this. but thanks to Audible, we have these audio books which are available. And I constantly listen to Louis Hay, because I love the entire concept of healing modality that she's talking about and the affirmations. So I keep listening to her, You Can Heal Your Life. Louis Hay, You Can Heal Your Life. So that's something which is, I've been listening this for quite some time, but I enjoy. I keep on listening to it again and again.
Interesting. And what are the characteristics of the best boss or a mentor or a coach you ever had, and what made that person great for you?
One is definitely to, how do I put this? This is a tough one, yeah. Best boss kaun tha yaar? I always consider myself as a best boss. because people say, Archana, so wherever I've been there, my team has really loved me, and even today. But let me think. I had somebody in the executive.
Somebody who yes. would have had a, yes. like a role model.
Yes. So one person definitely I can think of on, from the consulting, the HR background that I come from. One is the person who is not with his or her designation, too much attached to his or her designation. So you can be a VP, you can be a CEO, but you need to be grounded. Mm-hmm. It is not your designation which matters. What matters is your connect to people at different level. So to be a leader, please keep all your hats aside and be a human first. And be a human first. Trust me, if somebody can do that, they are the best leaders. The moment you are the true human who are understanding the other people and relationships, you're fantastic. Mm-hmm. You're fantastic for me.
And are there any tools that you use on a daily basis to be a better you, other than the laughter?
Absolutely, absolutely. In fact, one of the core thing apart from laughter is definitely Reiki. So Reiki is something which I really, really love, and along with laughter yoga, Reiki has transformed my life. Like how it has, it helps me to bring my intentions in reality too. At the same time, helps in healing my people around me. So every single day, at least 18 minutes is minimum. Otherwise, there are time where it goes at least for half an hour to 45 minutes. The second thing that I definitely use is music. Music is life for me. So that could be kirtan, that could be, and again, music depends on mood. So if it is raining, it would be some nice Hindi Bollywood romantic songs. If it is evening, it is more of spiritual. And if it is in the night when I'm unwinding, it could be again, Bollywood Kishore Kumar hits or something. But music is life for me. I live with music every single day. So these are a few things. Meditation, yes. Reiki, yes. My gratitude. So I have recorded my own voice of affirmations, which keep on changing. I record it. So what I do is when I'm cooking or when I'm even bathing, so these affirmations keep on playing in my home. So I'm listening to it, and this is how, see, mind is wavering so much. Here. Any moment you can be trapped with some negative thoughts and all of that. So these are the simple practices which really, really help you to stay grounded and positive. So yes, listening to my own voice, which are affirmations, which I create as and when, every fortnight, the affirmation keeps on changing because I know what I want for the coming week or so on. And I listen to them. And of course, Reiki meditation, praying and music. This is life. Yeah. And eating nice food. Fresh, homemade, nice food.
So in continuation, are there any habit you're practicing which has made you successful in whatever you're doing?
I would definitely say Reiki, because it has transformed my life. Along with laughter yoga, it is Reiki, which I remember when Dad was in ICU with a major massive heart attack, and doctors gave up and he was on ventilator, and they said, we have to do a bypass on ventilator, and everybody gave up. And I said, no, it was Reiki. It was meditation. It was surrender. It was prayer, which really, really transformed this entire situation. And I could only visualize that he's sitting next to me in the flight. We are grabbing our favorite cup of coffee, and he loves one of the cake, and how I'm flying back to Bangalore. And that intention has come true. So yes, these are something which are very, very beautiful.
So Archana, we have come to an end of this interview. And before that, I have one last question to ask. And before I ask you that, how can people get in touch with you to get more insight, collaborate? Where can they reach out to you?
Sure. I will be more than happy. One, they can check my website, which is www.laughteryogaindia.org. And second, just if you remember my name, which is Archana Rao. And if you remember Archana Rao, you should definitely remember Laughter Yoga. So Google on Laughter Yoga with Archana now. That's the brand I've created for myself, because my face, my name is a brand for Laughter Yoga India. I'm there on Facebook, I'm there on Insta, I'm there on LinkedIn and YouTube with the name of Laughter Yoga with Archana Rao. And of course, I'm going to share my email ID and mobile number too, so you guys can reach out to me. And I'm always and always ready to support and guide. And laugh with you, for sure. Most important, so much of gyan is fine, but I'm going to laugh with you for sure. Reach out to me if you want to laugh with me. Yeah.
Sure. On a closing note, and that last question, Archana, your advice to people who are new and want to accelerate their career?
When it comes to career, it is very, very important to keep upgrading yourself. Learning and unlearning is the key. Whether it is IT, with any industry, if you look at it, things are changing rapidly. I mean, what you have learned now, next 6 months or 1 year, I cannot, a simple example of Laughter Yoga. Can I give the same 10 exercises that I've been giving? People will say, "Arey yaar, she's doing the same thing," right? So I bring in innovation. You need to keep on learning and learning and learning. So to all those people in their careers, the only thing that your life purpose is to keep learning. And of course, at times, unlearn also, because life always gives you surprises. Sometimes you need to unlearn too, depending upon the situation. So be open to learn and unlearn, to bring in that completion or bring in that wow moment for whatever you are doing. And most important, have that passion for whatever you are doing, whatever role or job you are doing. It's very, very important that you enjoy doing it and have that passion. Otherwise, it would be a disaster that you would be doing for your life.
That's amazing one and a great insight, Archana. So guys, all the links and resources which we have discussed in this episode will be available in my show notes page of my podcast, Stars of Learning, and also on my website, prajvitaknowledge.com, that is prajvitaknowledge.com, for your quick reference. Thank you so much, Archana, for being on this show. And yes, it's important to realize life is beautiful when we are laughing. So keep laughing and laugh for health and happiness. Ho, ho, ha, ha, ha. Thank you so much.
So let's end with a beautiful laughter for all our audience who have been having a lot of patience to listen to us so beautifully. So you guys, wherever you are, whenever you are listening this, make sure you are laughing with me and Jyoti nicely. So here we go. Before we end, hearty laughter for all of you. Fantastic. Thank you. Thank you, Jyoti. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Really appreciate your time, Archana. It's been great to have you on my show.
In fact, I thoroughly enjoy with you this entire session, because it brought in so much of memories, and I'm super, super happy that you made this possible, because through you, there are so many people, not just today, over years, who are going to listen to what is Laughter Yoga and bring this transformation in their lives. So, and stay blessed, and I'm happy that you're laughing and continue laughing. I really love your energy. It's fantastic. Thank you so much, Jyoti, for doing this.
Thank you.
So friends, I hope you enjoyed this conversation. And if you have got any learning or motivated hearing to this show, then make sure you share this podcast with your friends and post it on all social media platforms like Facebook, Twitter, Insta. And do tag us and let your friends know about this amazing information you have learned, and let this piece of information help many others to engage, enlighten, and empower. Thank you so much for your patience and tuning into this show. Bye for now. Take good care of yourself and go out and do something engaging, enlightening, and empowering.